The U.S. Navy has started the process of analyzing airframes, targeting systems, artificial intelligence-enabled sensors, new weapons, and engine technology for its next-generation fighter jet. Several reports indicate that the U.S. Navy's next-generation fighter could be similar to the U.S. Air Force's NGAD, or Next Generation Air Dominance aircraft. The fighters will most likely be equipped with laser weapons, upgraded stealth technology, and work with drones, which would enable the pilot to send the UAV to potentially dangerous areas like those protected by advanced air defense systems. Reports state that the U.S. Navy would prefer a sixth-generation manned fighter jet as opposed to an advanced unmanned aerial vehicle. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what will U.S. Navy's carrier-based sixth-generation fighter be capable of. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. A sixth-generation fighter is supposed to take some of the features of fifth-generation fighters, like stealth, to the next level, as well as add several more advanced elements. Though at an early stage of R&D, several distinct characteristics common to nearly all nations' sixth-generation fighter concepts have emerged. 1. More modular design, going beyond wing hardpoints with primary aircraft components able to be swapped out within hours to optimize for the mission requirements and easing the introduction of future upgrades. 2. Single-seat-only cockpits with training occurring mostly in simulators. 3. Optionally manned with the same airframe capable of conducting remote-controlled or AI-controlled missions. 4. Controlling a swarm of drones acting in both a defensive and reconnaissance role for the controlling fighter. 5. Battlefield data fusion with the aircraft acting as a network node capable of receiving and relaying data to multiple other platforms, such as other aircraft, ground vehicles, or satellites, and processing that data on board to dynamically generate new target lists or update mission parameters on the fly. 6. Increased range standoff weapons with the drones conducting reconnaissance within enemy airspace and supplying targeting data to the fighter, which remains safely outside enemy airspace. 7. Greater electrical power generation to enable equipping directed energy weapons, such as laser close-in weapon system. This will enable the jet to intercept incoming missiles. 8. Virtual cockpit helmet-mounted display, allowing the pilot 360-degree vision and doing away with cockpit displays. Talking about the sixth-generation fighter, Chief of Naval Operations Admiral Mike Gilday said, "What the aviation combatant of the future looks like? I don't know yet. I think there's going to be a requirement to continue to deliver a seaborne launched vehicle through the air that'll deliver an effect downrange. I do think that will likely be a mix of manned and unmanned. The platform which they launch from, I'm not sure what that's going to look like." As of now, there is no information on who will design the sixth-generation fighter, as it's still being conceptualized. Since this kind of program is very effort and cost-intensive, we can assume that it will most likely be one of the aerospace behemoths – Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, or Boeing. The new aircraft will likely be a two-engine, multi-role stealth fighter capable of handling air-to-air and air-to-ground roles under the same mission. It's presumed that, like the U.S. Air Force's NGAD, the Navy fighter will ensure the service's air dominance in future conflicts when facing the fighters of rivals. The aircraft will also have the ability to conduct precision air-to-ground missions, with special attention being given to make it suitable for carrying out anti-ship warfare. There is almost no information on what are the capabilities of the jet, what features are already developed, and what are in the pipeline. People having knowledge of this matter have indicated that the U.S. Navy wants 50% greater range for the new fighter as compared to the older fighter jets. The longer range will enable it to fight farther from the aircraft carrier and keep the aircraft carrier outside the range of the enemy's strike range. This is important since near-peer rivals like Russia and China have already developed potent long-range anti-ship weapons. For example, Russia has Kinzhal, Dagger, hypersonic air-launched ballistic missile, which reportedly has a range of approximately 1,250 miles, or 2,000 kilometers, and a top speed of more than 10 times the speed of sound. China has Dongfeng 21, which is a two-stage, solid-fuel rocket, single-warhead, medium-range ballistic missile, MRBM. The missile is designed to be fired from land-based mobile launchers. Its variant, the DF-21D, is said to be the world's first anti-ship ballistic missile, ASBM. According to the U.S. National Air and Space Intelligence Center, the missile has a maximum range of around 1,450 kilometers, or 900 miles. Viewers may note that on March 5, 2019, the U.S. military had successfully completed the first-ever test flight of its new stealth fighter drone, the XQ-58A Valkyrie. The project falls under the Air Force Research Laboratory's Low-Cost Attritable Aircraft Technology, LCAAT, program. The program is initiated to develop cheaper, unmanned tactical aircraft. Valkyrie is conceptualized as part of the Loyal Wingman initiative, where it's supposed to fly alongside a manned aircraft and provide mission support. It's likely the U.S. Navy's sixth-generation fighter will be able to work in tandem with these kinds of aircraft. Sukhoi Su-57 is advertised by Russia to be a fifth-generation fighter, though it has issues with its stealth characteristics. Even then, the Su-57 program is massively delayed. 76 of these jets are expected to be deployed by 2028. The Kremlin previously planned to have 150 of these aircrafts in service by 2020. Chinese Chengdu J-20, which is also touted to be fifth-generation fighter, is still not in serial production. It has suspect stealth characteristics and is also having engine problems. The fighter currently can't supercruise, which is one of the core features of the fifth-generation fighter. In the meantime, the U.S. military has already developed and deployed two true fifth-generation fighters, F-22 Raptor and F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. This has been possible due to early planning, a lot of investment in R&D, as well as the futuristic vision of the leadership. Most analysts will bet that the U.S. will be the first to field a sixth-generation fighter, and rivals will be playing catch-up. It is to be noted that America is already in the process of deploying the Ford-class supercarriers to carry the next-generation fighter. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.